fast. I see Chief Bryant. He's running across the street right now, and he's going to give us an update and let us kind of know what can you tell us right now, Chief, as far as are they getting a handle on these fires, your men?
Well, the reports that I'm getting from the fire in the southeast part of the city, they think they're making some good progress down there. This fire up here in the northeast part, now it's still going pretty good. We have a lot of resources up there and we're doing our best, but we're just having some real issues with access to the fire because of the dense vegetation and the ground and the lay of the land and so forth. So it's making things a little bit more difficult up there. Plus the winds are still blowing fairly well right now, and it's just making it a pretty challenging situation.
Can you talk to me a little bit? We've had to do some evacuations over the last day and a half here. How have those been going? Have those been going fairly smoothly?
From what I've heard from the police department and other law enforcement agencies who are assisting us with that effort, people are cooperating fairly well, and we certainly appreciate that because, again, we have to make their safety our number one priority. And if they assist us with that by getting themselves out of harm's way, that's just much less work for us.
What can you tell us right now? You mentioned over in the northeast side of the city that the vegetation, I mean, what kind of an effort does it really, what do you guys have to do to try and get fires under control in that particular kind of terrain?
Well, even with some of our four-wheel drive fire apparatus, some of these areas are very difficult to access because how thick and dense the vegetation is. So in some cases, there's no way to get to the main part of the fire. And so you have to try and position yourself and be ahead of the fire to know when you can get water on it and try and control it at those points.
Meteorologist Rusty McCraney said that he was overhearing some situations where they were having trouble getting water to some areas. Has that been something that you guys have had trouble doing?
No, we haven't had water supply problems really throughout this incident. We do have some hydrants, obviously, in the area. Plus, a lot of the apparatus that we're using are the large supply tankers that we fill up. And they go to the forward areas and keep refilling the fire apparatus that are actually fighting the fire.
You have any, at this point, any timeline? Or do you think that you'll be able to have both of these fires contained, or is it just too early to tell?
It's just too early to tell right now. Again, hopefully, again, when the sun sets and maybe the wind lays a little bit, that'll give us another opportunity to, get some control of this situation. And the fire in the northeast and the fire in the southeast both, both of those are encroaching on, one, the turnpike in the northeast and I-40 to the south. So those are some good fire breaks for us that we'll try and take advantage of if the fire progresses to that point.
All right. Thank you, Chief. I appreciate it. And once again, trying to get a handle on two fires that are burning in the metro right now. Reporting live, Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.